Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today I'm going to show you how to create a radial wipe effect in Premiere Pro 2024. Okay, so the radial wipe was an effect in older versions of Premiere Pro that were more often used for creating things like pie charts and also for creating like circular progress bars. But for a long time now, that effect has been in the obsolete folder in the effects panel, and in the more recent version of Premiere Pro 2024, it's been removed entirely. So that begs the question, how do we create a radial wipe now? And it's actually very easy to do in the Essential Graphics panel. So here's how we do it. I'm going to go over to my toolbar and I want to select the ellipse tool, and then I'm going to hold down the shift key to create a perfect circle, and I'm going to click and drag to create a circle in my program monitor. And let's turn this red, and I'll also make sure that this is nice and centered in my frame. And then the next thing I want to do is I actually want to cut off one side of this circle, so I'm only seeing one side of it. So to do that, I'm going to add a rectangle here. I'm going to click new layer and then rectangle, and I'll change the color of this just so I can see it a bit clearer. And then what I want to do is reposition this so that it's cutting off half of the circle. But before I do this, I just want to make sure that I have snapping turned on so I can snap to the edges of everything. So I'm going to select my program monitor and go over to my view menu, and I'm going to tick snap in program monitor. And now I can move this rectangle to the very center of my circle, and I'll expand out these edges just so we're covering it up. And then to mask out the other side of the circle, I'm just going to select this shape and then go down the bottom here and tick mask with shape. So now we're only seeing one side of that circle. And then to actually create that animated radial wipe effect, I'm going to use the mirror effect. So I'm going to go over to my effects panel and I'll search for mirror. And then I'm going to click and drag this to the top of my layer stack up here. And then I'm going to go over to my effect controls panel, and you can see we've got two settings here, reflection center and reflection angle. Now for the reflection center, we need this value here where it's 1920, which is actually the width of my sequence at the moment. I want that to be the position of the circle in the center here. So if I select my circle, I can see that the X value here is 960. So I want it to be that, but I also want to subtract 0.5. And just to clarify what I'm saying there, I'm saying the reflection angle should be the horizontal position of the circle minus 0.5. So I'll jump back to my effect controls panel, and I'm going to set this to 960, but of course 960 minus 0.5, so this should be 959.5. And now we are perfectly in the center of that circle. And now I can actually add my animation here. What I'm going to do is add a keyframe for the reflection angle. I'm going to keep this at zero. And then I'm going to move towards the end of the graphic, and I'm going to turn this up to 180. So now we have an animation that looks like this. Of course, if we were turning this into a pie chart, we probably don't want it to go all the way around, so I'll probably just back this off a bit like that. Now, if we are making this as a pie chart, the whole idea is that there's another circle underneath this that's a different color. And we can do that easily over here just by duplicating our original circle. So I'm going to duplicate this, right click and duplicate, and I'm going to set the color of this one to maybe like a blue color like that. And then I'm going to drag it to the very bottom of the layer stack. Of course, now that mask that we created is also masking out that blue circle that we've just created. So to make sure that the mask is only affecting that red circle, what I'm going to do is select these three layers here, and I'm going to add them into their own group. And when you add a mask into a group, it only affects the layers within that group. So now we have a nice pie chart animation that looks like this. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful, and if you did, please like and subscribe, and maybe check out some of these other videos.